Hello viewers, this is my review of the ProBox X2 Air. ProBox was kind enough to send me their latest model, the X2 Air. And the specifications of this box: up to 4K 60 frames per second, Android 6 and S905X quad-core processor, 2GB of RAM, 16GB of storage, Wi-Fi 2.4 and 5 GHz, and audio over the HDMI or digital SPDF. Now let's open the box. The first thing is the weight. It feels heavier than other Android smart boxes. This is the front with an LED inside. Luckily enough, the LED is not super bright. And on the left side, a normal USB and a micro SD card slot. And on the back, the 5V power plug, one USB slot, the HDMI connector, LAN cable, and the SPDIF connector. And on the right side, you will find the Wi-Fi antenna connector. And this is what you will find inside the box: a manual with some instructions, the remote controller, the 5V power adapter, a very short HDMI cable, and the Wi-Fi antenna. This is the Remote Plus. You can choose to buy the box with or without the Remote Plus. I highly recommend to buy the box with the Remote Plus to get way better experience. If you hold the remote up, the mouse pointer on your screen will go up. Point it down, the mouse pointer on your screen will go down. I guess you know what happened with the left or right. It's like the remote controller of the Nintendo Wii. Everything is connected. Let's switch this box on. This is the home screen and a stock remote controller. Navigate through the menu works fine, but the mouse pointer function works also with arrow keys, and this is a pain in the ass. This is a fast forward, and this is why the Remote Plus controller is a must buy. Here it is, it's also possible to navigate with the arrow keys, but not all Android apps have arrow key support, and then you must use the mouse pointer, and that's the biggest advantage of this Remote Plus controller. Point the mouse everywhere you want and hit the OK button. Hold the OK button and you can swipe over your screen, like your finger on your phone or your tablet. Now, so this is the home screen, with the tabs like movies and TV shows, music, games, blah blah blah. You are able to add apps to the menus. Hit the plus button and select your app. This is the pre-installed app list, except Horizon Go, Radio FM, Real Racing 3 and the Speed Test app. The Google Play Store is available, so you can install every Android app. Some information about the box, and yep, it's running Android 6.0.1. Let's start Kodi. I guess this is the most used program for anyone who buys this box. And here's some Kodi information. Now a file test. I use the same files as in my previous Kodi box reviews. Let's start with a common X264 1080p file, and this must be no problem, of course. The second file had some problems on the next boxes with Kodi, but runs smoothly outside Kodi, and this is exact same on this box. The third file, the same problems. Now let's test the same files in the Android Movie Player. No problem at all, so it's a Kodi problem, and this box is perfectly capable to play these codecs. And now back to Kodi, and yep, this file works well. And the last two files, the spoiler alert, they both run smoothly. Let's test the connection speed, first on Wi-Fi 5G. It's running steady, just above the 100 Mbps. My connection speed is 150 Mbps. Let's swap to my 2.4G network. Just above the 50 Mbps. Not bad at all for 2.4G. The Wi-Fi is off, it's cable time. Around 100 Mbps. So this is also the limit of the 100 Mbps network connector on the ProBox. So 5G Wi-Fi is the fastest connection, but you need a good Wi-Fi coverage. The last part of this video is Real Racing 3. I use my Xbox controller to play this game. This is a game with high quality graphics for an Android box, but it plays very well. I feel like a real race driver now. So this is the end of my video. I hope I provided you good information about this ProBox X2. If you have any questions, leave a message below. This video is over. Bye bye.